things. We're trying to understand the behavior of baleen whales, of minke whales and humpback whales. The thing that's most important is to make sure that the animals that are here, that are recovering from commercial whaling, that are dealing with the face of climate change, are able to do that without having their prey affected. This research is really important for minke whales because there are so many unknowns with these animals. We know that they associate with sea ice, but we really know nothing about their behavior underwater. And that's critical in this part of the world, especially because the Antarctic Peninsula is changing very quickly. One kind of tag that we put on lasts for about 24 hours, and it measures the very fine scale movement and behavior of the animals. The other are satellite tags that we put onto the animals that will last for up to a month or two, and those will show us more of the broad scale movement patterns and distribution of these animals throughout the Antarctic summer. From looking at the video from the tag, we can see that this animal spends a lot of time in open water, but it also spends a fair bit of time in sea ice. We can see when it feeds as well, and what's amazing to me is how fast the animal is and how quickly it can feed, and then how quickly again it can feed a second time. And what we really hope to learn by putting tags on these whales is what's the critical time that these animals need to feed, and where are those locations where they need to feed, and that can tell us very directly where we're likely to have overlap and competition with something like the krill fishery. One of the reasons I think this research is really important is because it gives us a much better insight about the kinds of habitats that they require. And that can give us some really specific goals for how we want to conserve this area, what kind of places we want to protect, and the habitats that these animals need. If we can define those, makes it a lot easier for us to set up something like a marine protected area that affords them protection from things like the removal of krill or changes in their habitat.